Hi, it's Matt with One Week Bath and another edition in our series of short videos on bathroom design, product selection, and remodeling. Today we're going to talk about the different types of bathroom sinks.
It's another edition of Soak It Up with Matt Plaskoff, bathroom design and remodeling.
Now the bathroom sink can simply be a bowl that collects the water from the faucet and then leaves the bathroom, or it can be a design element and even a focal point. There are basically four types of sinks. There are overmount sinks, undermount sinks, semi-recessed sinks, and vessel sinks. Let's start with the overmount sink. This type of sink is placed on top of the counter surface once a hole is cut out for the sink, and the edges of the sink seal the finish and the connection between the counter and the sink. Often these sinks can be stylistic and have pretty edges so that they're not only functional, but they also are a design feature. The great thing about these sinks is that you may be able to replace one without counter damage, in contrast to an undermount where the hole has to be the exact shape and size of the replacement sink. The negative to using an overmount sink is that the raised lip of the sink interrupts the level surface of the countertop, and it creates a dam for water and doesn't allow you to simply wipe the counter into the sink. These sinks come in a variety of shapes, from rectangle to oval. Also, they have faucet options where you can mount the faucet to the sink or to the countertop. The second type of sink is the undermount sink. I would say this is the most common option. The sink attaches to the underside of the countertop, and the edges of the counter where they meet the sink must be finished. The benefit to the undermount sink is the maximization of countertop space, as well as the ability to wipe the counter directly into the sink. The undermount sink must be installed correctly to avoid future dropping of the sink as it's supported from underneath, and this is important. And these sinks come in a variety of shapes, from rectangle to oval. Some do have interior designs that you can't really typically see until you get on top of the sink, so design-wise, it's really just shape that influences design most of the time. Also, the faucet is typically mounted on the countertop, occasionally out of the wall. The third option is a semi-recessed sink. This option is designed to sit partially above and partially below the countertop. The reason this is important is that it allows for a reasonable depth sink without a lot of height above the counter. We'll talk more about this when we discuss vessels, but the issue is the type of faucet that might be required when using this type of a sink. The semi-recessed sink is unique in style and adds that effortless wow factor to your bathroom. Similar to the overmount sink, the negative is that you can't just wipe the counter into the sink, and they can take up a larger amount of the counter space. They come in ovals, rounds, rectangles, everything in between. Faucets can typically be mounted to the sink, to the counter, or coming out of the wall. And the key is that the faucet clears the height of the sink. The final option is the vessel sink. A vessel sink sits on top of the counter for a visually appealing look. The vessel is clearly a design element and a statement. There are many options, including ceramic, glass, stainless steel, stone, copper, marble. You can achieve all kinds of looks with these sinks. There are two things to be conscious about when you're choosing a vessel. First, if the vessel is a typical height of about 5 to 6 inches, you'll have to consider how high your cabinet is. Do you want the top of the sink to be way up at 40 inches, or should you drop your cabinet down a bit lower in height? Second, the faucet selection is critical. The spout and the handles have to be higher than the vessel. Have no fear, there are a pretty large variety of faucets designed for the vessel type sink. You can also opt for a wall mount faucet, but that'll be more expensive and has its own set of issues. You can see our Soak It Up on faucets for that information. So there you have it, a primer on sink selection. Thanks for watching. Check out our other videos on YouTube. Hit that subscribe button for more videos to come. In the meantime, follow us on social media for more about bathroom design and remodeling, and check out our website for inspiration and information for your bathroom of your dreams.